Thus, by making the elders sole arbiters in the trial of life, he contrived to charge old age with a greater weight of honor than that which is accorded to the strength of mature manhood. And assuredly, such a contest as this must appeal to the zeal of mortal man beyond all others in a supreme degree. Fair, doubtless, are contests of gymnastic skill, yet are they but trials of bodily excellence. But this contest for the seniority is of a higher sort. It is an ordeal of the soul itself. In proportion, therefore, as the soul is worthier than the body, so must these contests of the soul appeal to a stronger enthusiasm than their bodily antitypes. And yet another point may well excite our admiration for Lycurgus largely. It has not escaped his observation that communities exist where those who are willing to make virtue their study and delight fail somehow in ability to add to the glory of their fatherland. That lesson the legislator laid to heart, and in Sparta he enforced as a matter of public duty the practice of virtue by every citizen. And so it is that, just as man differs from man in some excellence according as he cultivates or neglects to cultivate it, this city of Sparta, with good reason, outshines all other states in virtue, since she, and she alone, has made the attainment of a high standard of noble living a public duty. And was this not a noble enactment, that, whereas other states are content to inflict punishment only in cases where a man does wrong against his neighbor, Lycurgus imposed penalties no less severe on him who openly neglected to make himself as good as possible? For this, it seems, was his principle. In the one case where a man is robbed or defrauded or kidnapped and made a slave of, the injury of the misdeed, whatever it is personal to the individual so maltreated.